Conservative, opinionated outsider with no political experience tries to unseat a sitting Democratic senator in one of the bluest states in the nation. That state, or Commonwealth rather, is Massachusetts. And the would-be candidate is Kurt Schilling. Joining me now, former ESPN commentator, current radio host of the Kurt Schilling Show on the Howie Carr Network, and Major League Baseball legend Kurt Schilling. Sir, thank you so much for joining us. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Jack. Thank you, Jake. Thanks.
So you say you're going to run for Senate, try to unseat Democratic Senator Elizabeth Warren, as long as your wife, Shonda, signs off. Has she signed off?
Well, first off, I'm thinking about it. That was really, as I look back, that was pretty much an unfair corner to put her into. This is, if this is a decision I do decide to go forward with, it'll be a complete family decision. When you look at, I think, the state of media and the politics now, conservative families are fair game. And I don't know that they want to be put through that, and I don't know that I would want to put them through that. So that discussion hasn't been finalized yet.
Are you leaning one way or the other?
I think it's something I would like to do, yes. But again, I'm married. I've been married for 24 years this November, and I have four kids. If we're not all on board with doing it, I'm not going to do it, because you can't. I don't think, as a person who is not a career politician, I don't think you can enter this arena tepid or timid or with reservations. You have to go, which is kind of how I'm either in neutral or fifth gear. So, you know, that's going to have to be a family buy-in.
All right, fair enough. So let me ask you, Massachusetts, obviously a very, very blue state. Hillary Clinton currently beating Donald Trump in the polls there by 25 points. You are a conservative. You have endorsed Donald Trump. In order to win, you're going to have to get Hillary Clinton voters to vote for you.
Well, I'll tell you, Jake, honestly, I think, like in a lot of places, I don't think the politics match the populace in Massachusetts. I think in conversing and being involved in this state and being around, I think the state is much more moderate than politicians and media would have people believe. But at the end of the day, yeah, I'm going to have to convince people that might otherwise vote blue to vote not blue. I'm a registered independent. I'm not sure how that would play. I probably would switch to the Republican Party, even though I'm probably as fed up with the right as I am with the left now. You know, but again, yeah, I'm going to have to convince people. And at the end of the day, if I can, I don't win.
So if you were to run, obviously, one of the issues that would be brought up by your opponents would be the fact that you were let go from ESPN after sharing a meme on Facebook, a man dressed as a woman, the caption, quote, "Let him into the restroom with your daughter, or else you're a narrow-minded, judgmental, unloving, racist bigot who needs to die." You're going to have to defend that post to a lot of progressive voters. You're also going to have to defend retweeting an image that likened 5 to 10% of Muslims worldwide, which computes to about 80 million Muslims, to Nazis. Are those?
No. That's not true. That's not true. No, I compared compared Muslim extremists to Nazis. That extremist part is, I know it's tricky, but that's the part that gets left out by everybody. That was a if you take the word extremist out, that's an incredibly racist post, which is why the word extremist was in there. And you could argue, and listen, after that, there have been multiple stories about the comparisons. There is a very long-standing connection between Islam and the Nazi Party, and you can go back to before the Second World War and talk to that one. And as far as the transgender post, the only thing I'm going to defend in that is what I said. It wasn't my post. I was reposting a post, and I had commented on it. And my comment was, men should use the men's room and women should use the women's room. Why do we need the federal government telling us otherwise?
The last question I have for you, sir, it has to do with Donald Trump, because if you do run, I'm sure the Democrats will try to tie Donald Trump to you and make you the Massachusetts version of Donald Trump. You've not only endorsed Donald Trump back in May, but you wrote at the time on your blog that Trump's commentary on women was uncomfortable. Since then, we've seen a tape emerge of Mr. Trump seemingly bragging about what sounds a lot like sexual assault. In your initial response on Twitter, you seemed to dismiss the lewd video and said it was just Mr. Trump talking big. That's your term. Is that all it is to you, that it's just him talking big?
Well, listen, Jake, you graduated from Dartmouth. You're a pretty smart guy. And I would argue, as a moderate, as a conservative, one of the few people I think still left in the media that tries to go straddle the fence and be fair and objective. I'm curious as to why we spent 7 or 8 news cycles talking about disgustingly crass, inappropriate, sexist comments he made 10 years ago over the fact that every single day WikiLeaks is showing us that Hillary Clinton is exactly the criminal we thought she was. And when you look at that, no one condones what he said. But when you take the liberal perspective of my comments, they go from me not condoning or me not condemning the comments to me advocating for child molestation and pedophilia. It's that jump, and people are smarter than that. But that's the argument that they go to. And I would like to ask you a question, honestly,
sure.
Jake, as someone who is going to, I'm assuming you're going to vote for Hillary Clinton.
No.
I'm assuming you're not going to vote for Donald Trump.
I don't vote for presidential races.
Okay, so I would like to ask you something about as a person who's practicing the Jewish faith and has since you were young. I don't understand, and this is the amateur non-politician in me. I don't understand how people of Jewish faith can back the Democratic Party, which over the last 50 years has been so clearly anti-Israel, so clearly anti-Jewish Israel, that I don't know what else would need to be done, said, or happen for people to understand that the Democratic Party is allied with Israel only because we have agreements in place that make them have to be.
Well, I don't speak for Jews, and I don't support the Democratic Party or the Republican Party. I would imagine, just to try to answer your question, that one of the reasons many Jews are Democrats has more to do with Democrats' support for social welfare programs and that sort of thing than it does for Israel.
That's fair.
And I know that a lot of Jews who are very strong supporters of Israel do support the Republican Party, but
right.
I don't speak for Jews, but Kurt
right.
Schilling,
no, and I know you don't.
I
know you don't. I just always find it
it's
a great conversation for somebody of your faith to because I want to understand the reasons behind some of those things. So I appreciate that.
All right. Well, we can keep in touch and we can have more conversations and hope you'll come back. Thank you.